हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम वर्षा गुप्ता फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बायोटेक्नोलॉजी, छत्रपति शाहू जी महाराज यूनिवर्सिटी कानपुर. विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट यूकैरियोटिक सेल. इन दिस वीडियो लर्नर्स वुड बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड यूकैरियोटिक सेल, डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन यूकैरियोटिक एंड प्रोकैरियोटिक सेल, फीचर्स एंड फंक्शंस ऑफ डिफरेंट कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ एनिमल यूकैरियोटिक सेल. सो यूकैरियोटिक सेल, एज द नेम इंडिकेट, यू मीन्स ट्रू. कैरियन वर्ड्स, कैरियोटिक वर्ड इज रिलेटेड टू न्यूक्लियाई. So, true nuclei containing cells are eukaryotic cells. They contain a defined nucleus, membrane-bound nucleus, and extensive internal membranes that enclose other compartments, which are the organelles. So, eukaryotic cell have well-defined nucleus with membrane, along with membranous organelles. And the region which is present inside the cell is referred to as protoplasm. Protoplasm has cytoplasm, comprising of cytosol and the organelles, along with the and the nucleus. So cytoplasm is everything inside the cell except nucleus, while protoplasm has cytoplasm plus nucleus. All the members of plants and animal kingdom, they belong to eukaryotes. In this we have fungi also. Fungi can exist in multicellular form, which are molds, or in unicellular forms, which are yeasts. And the protozoans, which are primitive animals which are exclusively unicellular, they also belong to eukaryotes. So these are amoeba, paramecium, entamoeba, histolytica, etc. And eukaryotic cells are commonly larger as compared to plant cells, as compared to prokaryotic cells, and they are bigger than bacteria. So amoeba can be 0.5 mm long, and an ostrich egg can be seen by naked eye, which is initially the single cell. And all the cells, they have thought to have evolved from common progenitor, because the structure and function, right from the prokaryotes till the eukaryotes, the structure and function of the molecules and the components of the cell have similarity. And archaea and eukaryotes, they have thought to have diverged from two bacteria. Archaeans, they grow at very unusual environment, which are halophiles, which are salt loving, and thermoacidophiles, which are heat and acid loving. While there are some which are oxygen, live in oxygen free condition and generate methane. Now this slide shows the differences between prokaryotic and eukaryotic cell. So this panel shows prokaryotes, this panel shows eukaryotes. So true nucleus with nuclear membrane is absent. Its nucleus is present as single chromosome in the form of nucleoid, while eukaryotic cells, they have well defined nucleus with nuclear membrane. And chromosome number is usually single in prokaryotes, while it varies between different individual species. Extra chromosomal DNA in prokaryotes is present as plasmid or bacteriophage. Extra chromosomal DNA is normally absent in eukaryotes, but DNA is present in mitochondria in animal cell and mitochondria and chloroplast in plant cell. And both the organelles, mitochondria and chloroplast, they are considered as semi-autonomous organelles, because they, for their functions, they are partly dependent upon nuclear genome, but partly they are responsible for their own functions. So they are semi autonomous, so half autonomous they are. So they contain DNA and 70S kind of ribosome. We'll be shortly discussing about ribosomes. The cells may be unicellular in prokaryotes, but cyanobacteria also shows multicellularity. And here in eukaryotes, we have right from unicellular protozoa to multicellular human being. We are the highest in the hierarchy. Size of the cell is generally smaller in bacteria in prokaryotes. Mycoplasma is even more smaller, and typical eukaryotic cell can be very big. Cell layers, 90% of the bacteria, they have cell wall. Mycoplasma are bacteria which lack cell wall. So in bacteria, outer layer is of glycocalyx. Then we have they have cell wall of peptidoglycan or mucopeptide. In gram-positive bacteria, they also have ticoic acid, and gram-negative, they have lipopolysaccharide. And gram-negative are considered to be more pathogenic as compared to gram-positive. And because of ticoic acid and high concentration of peptidoglycan, gram-positive bacteria are able to take up the gram stain. We have discussed it in the prokaryotic cell class. Animal cells, they lack cell wall, while plant cell wall is made up of cellulose, and fungal cell wall is made up of chitin and alpha and beta linked glucans. Cellular respiration in prokaryotic cell, it occurs in cellular membrane. The enzymes are present tightly attached to cellular membrane. In some, it is referred to as mesosome, but mesosome is not the unique feature. Some of the bacteria also lack mesosome. And cellular membrane infolding, they allow higher surface area, While in eukaryotic cell, mitochondria, which is semi-autonomous organelle also, which is powerhouse of the cell, it is double membranous organelle, it is semi-autonomous, contains DNA and 70S ribosome. So, cellular respiration occurs in mitochondria. In eukaryotes, we have three organelles which are double-layered, which have double-layered membrane. These are mitochondria, chloroplast and nuclei. While many of them, they have got single-layered, and some of them like ribosomes, they don't have any kind of covering or outer layer. So, ribosomes, they are made up of proteins and ribosomal RNA. This was questioned in the NEET. So, ribosomes are, they consist of protein and ribosomal RNA, and their site of synthesis is nucleolus in the nucleus. They are 70S type in cytoplasm, present in cytoplasm in the prokaryotic cell with 50S and 30S subunits. S is sedimentation coefficient. This was also questioned in NEET 2012. While in the eukaryotic cell, ribosomes are 80S type with 60S and 40S subunit. But eukaryotic cells, they have both 70S and 80S. 80S is present in the cytoplasm and 70S is present in mitochondria and chloroplast, which are semi-autonomous organelles. So, ribosomes of 70S types are present in mitochondria and chloroplast, while in nuclear, in the cytoplasm for translation of nuclear mRNA, 80S type of ribosomes are responsible, which are present on rough endoplasmic reticulum as well as free in the cytosol. Golgi apparatus, endoplasmic reticulum, both of them are absent in prokaryotic cell while they are present in eukaryotic cell. ER is rough and smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Reproduction is mostly asexual, and in conjugation also it is unidirectional transfer. While in eukaryotes, we have fusion of gametes. So, both the individuals, male and female, they are responsible for their characters in the next offspring. Molecules involved in division, polarity and shape are tubulin, actin and intermediate filament in the case of eukaryotic cell, while different kind of molecules which are tubulin related to bacterial protein, MREB and CRES and CTPA, they are responsible for cell division, polarity and shape in the case of prokaryotic cell. Cell division is binary fission, and here cell division occurs with the process of mitosis. Membrane bound organelles, lysosomes, peroxisomes, chloroplasts, all of them are absent in prokaryotic cell. While membrane bound organelles, they are a specialized membrane bound organelles, as we discussed, they are present in the eukaryotic cell. Lysosomes are present, peroxisomes are present, and chloroplasts are present in plant cell, which are semi-autonomous organelles. This was also a question of the NEET, which was asked in 2010. In the transcription, that is from DNA, RNA is produced. It occurs in the cytoplasm because prokaryotic cells don't have a nuclei. While the transcription process occurs in the nucleus in the case of eukaryotic cell for the nuclear genome, and for the chloroplastic and mitochondrial genome, it occurs in chloroplast and mitochondria respectively. In prokaryotic cell, translation occurs in occurs on ribosomes in the cytoplasm, and since they lack intron, so they don't have to do any kind of editing of RNA, mRNA. So, coupled transcription and translation, so both the processes, they can occur simultaneously. But in the case of eukaryotic cell, it the transcription occurs in the nucleus in the case of nuclear genome, and translation occurs in cytoplasm on a smooth rough endoplasmic reticulum, the rough endoplasmic reticulum which have ribosomes, or in the free ribosomes in the cytoplasm, and 70S ribosome in chloroplast and mitochondria. Centrosome and centrioles are absent in prokaryotic cell while they are present in eukaryotic cell. Vacuoles are usually absent, but if they are present, many very small gas vacuole may be present. While plant cell has very big vacuole, animal cell has small vacuole. So, this shows a typical diagram of eukaryotic animal cell. So, we'll have some of the features of plant cell as well. So, we have nucleus. This nucleus has nucleolus, chromatin, nuclear envelope and nucleoplasm. Nucleolus is the largest structure in the nuclei, which makes ribosomal subunit from protein and ribosomal RNA. So, this is the nucleolus, which is the largest structure in the nucleus. It was asked in NEET 2018. Chromatin is a DNA packaged with histone protein. Nuclear envelope is a membrane of the nucleus which has pores for the movement of molecules. Nucleoplasm is gelatinous sticky material present inside the nucleus. Peroxisomes, their name is peroxisome because they result in the byproduct hydrogen peroxide. And peroxisomes are typically involved in breakdown of long chain fatty acid through beta oxidation. And they are involved in formation of membrane, and their oxidation reaction is oxidation reaction product is hydrogen peroxide, so their name is peroxisome. So they are present. Endoplasmic reticulum can be rough endoplasmic reticulum or it can be smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Rough endoplasmic reticulum is a part of endomembrane system which is studded with ribosome, as we can see. Therefore, the name is rough, and it is involved in protein synthesis, protein folding, protein modification. quality control and transport. Partly protein modification occurs in rough ER and partly protein modification occurs in the Golgi bodies. So this was also a question they were asked in several examinations of NEET. And smooth endoplasmic reticulum, it is part of endomembrane system which doesn't have ribosomes. So the name is smooth. It is involved in production and metabolism of fats and steroid hormones and synthesis of lipids. It occurs in smooth endoplasmic reticulum. So then we have vacuoles. Very small sized vacuoles are present in animal cell. Mitochondria, which is powerhouse of the cell, they are abundant in the cell, which is involved in extensive activity, while their number can be decreased in the cells which are involved in lesser activity. And it is power of the house of the cell because it generates energy currency in the form of ATP by oxidative phosphorylation of glucose. This was also a question. Cytoplasm is the material which is inside the cell except nucleus. Then we have secretory vesicle. Golgi bodies are another very important organelle present in the eukaryotic cell, in which they have folded membrane. They are involved in secretion, protein modification, intracellular trafficking and transport. They are involved in glycosylation of proteins and lipids. So they generate glycoproteins and glycolipids. So this was also a question which was asked in previous year examinations. So they are important organelle for protein modification and intracellular trafficking and transport. Lysosomes are suicidal bags of the cell because they contain digestive hydrolytic enzymes, acid hydrolase, which digests worn out organelle, food particle or engulfed bacteria and viruses. And because this has a battery of these enzymes, and these enzymes help us to digest all the unused material of the cell, as well as if bacteria or viruses infection occurs in the cell, the lysosome is responsible for digestion of bacteria and viruses. So it is kind of suicidal bag of the cell and it contains a lot of hydrolytic enzyme. This question was asked in several examination and it has single membrane. Only double layered membrane, membranous organelles are nucleus, mitochondria and chloroplast. Ribosomes have no membrane and lysosome has got single membrane. Now cytoskeleton is made by intermediate filament which provide mechanical stability and hold organelles in place. Microtubules, these are largest cytoskeletal molecule made up of tubulin. They provide mechanical stability, help formation of mitotic spindle, organelle transport and cellular division. Microfilament or actin filament, these are thinnest filament which help in mechanical stability, amoeboid movement, motility of cell, changes in cell shape, endocytosis and exocytosis. And centrosome, which are involved in microtubule organizing center for chromosomal disjunctions, which are regulator of cell cycle progression, they are present in these cells. Now, eukaryotic cell, animal cell, it doesn't have a cell wall which is present in the plant cell. It doesn't have plastids like chloroplast, chromoplast and leucoplast which are present in plant cell. The storage material of the eukaryotic animal cell is glycogen, while in the plant cell it is starch. So these are some of the differences between plant and animal cell that we'll be taking up in the next class. Thank you so much.